Hello. There have been some changes to the X carriage since I did the video, assembly video for it. So I figured I will cover the changes that were made and do basically an update of the components that have changed and explain the principle behind the basically its operation. So we have the parts. The new part here is this rocker switch, or the rocker actuator thing. How it's used will become apparent in just a few seconds. All right, well, as per usual, let's put our bearing into the hot end retainer and centered. All right. To facilitate. By the way, do clean these holes out. Get a drill bit, either a 3 mm drill bit or the imperial cousin that's closest to 3 mm. Over 3 mm is better. There's not a whole lot of play you're going to be seeing from the carriage bolts, but you do want it to be able to rotate. To facilitate the said rotation, we are going to apply a little bit of grease. I'm using a cutout zip tie for this. Just a little will do the trick, but more doesn't hurt. And if it's on the outside, that's actually really well good too, because our nylon washers need to be as slippery as possible. Do, 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 do. Take our springs that I've already had put grease on. Grease on the springs just lets it work better and doesn't make sure it doesn't bind against itself or against the walls of the hot end retainer. I'm actually going to put a little bit of grease on the inside here because it's completely dry because this part just came out of off the other printer. These things love to fly away. The previous design had you do this complex maneuver where you put these together and then you snap this piece in. That's all gone now, thankfully. I'm gonna insert all of my M3 nuts. Kind of straight. These two nuts are for the belt clips. Basically using the one size down from the hex wrench we usually would be using on M3 screws. To guide the knot in. And then the same thing on all of these guys. That's good. They will get sucked in when we insert the carriage bolts. All right. Again, this is much easier now. This already has the grease on it, so use that later. Let's take our other bolt, put it here. This is sort of the middle carriage now that there's stuff hanging off the other end of it now. And we're gonna take our rocker actuator and put some grease on the inside of that as well, because it again needs to be able to slip. I'm also gonna add grease to both sides of it because it's gonna be sandwiched. And although there is plenty of clearance, I don't want it really touching the sides, or I don't want it rubbing against the sides too much. So should be pretty smooth. All right, that's good. Now let's actually mount the switch it's going to actuate against. Here's our just normal Z switch. For example, this is the X carriage switch. This is the same switch with a little plate removed. We don't need it. Actually using M2 screws, slightly different than the BOM, than the ones specified in the BOM. I'm actually gonna move the BOM to these screws because I can get them for in greater quantities and for much cheaper, and it's just a tiny little metal screw. There's no reason why I need to get these from McMaster, and in Imperial form nonetheless. All right, so this is our hot end mount. This is the Chimera version. You have the three holes and the two feed tubes. The retainer clips go in here, these little guys can just go here. And then I made a little divot over here to basically be able to get a tool in here of some sort. So you can push these down if you want to remove the bowden tubes. All right, so let's take one of our other carriage bolts, put it in thusly, put our neoprene washer on here for extra slipperiness, and then this guy's gonna go straight down. There's a little bit of a divot here to allow the spring to basically just slide under the plate that is going to push against for the rest of its life. You want it to make sure that it catches, the little catch here catches the thing on that side. And we're in. So, how does this work? Little M3 8mm screw that threads into plastic and acts as the adjustment screw for the actuator. Yep. So I'm bringing it down until it clicks, and then bring it out a quarter turn. So what happens when you actually press, when the hot end hits the bed, this swivels up. This part swivels up, it hits the rocker switch, and the rocker switch amplifies it about 2 to 1, and actually hits the switch. It's kind of hard to see because of the camera. But basically that's what's happening. So this thing swigs down and hits the switch because this thing came up because the hot end hit the bed. And you can dial in the sensitivity basically to have it a hair trigger almost. Okay. Put the other washer on here. And almost forgot the bearing. And then this part just slides on here. Basically found where the holes are. And if the spring is not cooperating, just kind of push it down. There we go. All right. So, first let's tighten this down. There's going to be a little bit of a weird tension where the screw is actually getting sucked in. And then you'll feel it fully tighten where it doesn't release the carriage back. Oh, it released. All right, there we go. Let's tighten this bad boy. Why is there trash on my parts? All right. You want to tighten this just enough to be snug, but for this part to keep moving back and forth. There we go. You almost can't tell that it's being depressed, and that's kind of what we want. We want almost no force to be applied to get this thing to actuate. Or little force, basically, but we want the travel to be minimized. So when the nozzle hits the bed, we want it to actuate within, you know, 0.2, 0.5 millimeters. 0.1 millimeter would be better because the rest of the flex of the gantry under the forces of it, basically you're hitting the bed with the nozzle. There's a lot of buckling and things like that. We want it to minimize this travel because the rest of the travel is going to factor into the Z offset. All right, let's put everything else really is the same as the older design, using 12 millimeter screws to mount the E3D hot end. Kind of need the X-axis end stop as well. Take our hot end. I rerouted the wires to point for the heaters to come out this way because when the hot end hits the bed and swivels down a bit, I want maximum travel on the wire, so I'm not really putting any too much stress on it. I do want to move these in so they're snug against the side. So let's do that now. Nope. There it is. I do have a ball end version of that, but I don't know where it is. All right, swing that out to the side and tighten. Slog back on. Same thing on the other end. much happier with this setup. I'm actually using little button head screws because I don't know where the baggie with these set screws went. Works good enough. Okay, let's mount the hot end. These wires are going to be really close to the heatsink. So you kind of want to bend the leads as close to the body as possible. And just make sure none of the wires are touching, none of the contacts are touching the middle of the hot end. All right, that's in. It's in. So if you take the hot end, the carriage now, and basically squeeze it, it feels like it doesn't move at all, but it does trigger, and that's what we want. Obviously, once all of this put together and the belts are put on, some of the geometry is going to change a little, so you will need to do a readjustment on the adjustment screw to basically get it to dial out any as much distance as you can out of the switch treble. Another thing to note, temperature is going to play we're talking about mechanical things here, and temperature is going to play a role because things are going to expand and contract. Getting kind of cold here, I know it's California, but still in the shop it gets fairly chilly. That's the jacket. So the grease gets a little gummy and the things contract a little bit. If you can, put a pause in your G-code, so when the carriage is above the bed, let it basically just sit above the hot bed for a while to let everything just kind of heat up, and so it works better before you adjust the screw here, because what you want to do is, this is going to be operating after the bed heat up, after the hot end is heated up. So if you make an adjustment while everything is cold, and then you go to print, your Z end stop may end up being triggered because you've already put too much pressure on here. When everything expanded, it just hit the switch, and now, you know, it thinks it already touched the bed and it's not going to home. So that's, you know, worst case scenario. Or it'll be too sensitive to where it triggers midair, and then it thinks midair is zero, and then when you go to print, the bed is actually like here. Has that happened to me on a very early version of this design, which had like four screws. That is very complicated. Anyway, let's mount this onto our gantry and continue as we were.